It is, perhaps, the strangest moment of a career arc for certain star NFL players. One day, with the winding down, you are no longer preparing for a Pro Bowl or playoff game. You are no longer peppered with questions about a lucrative off-season contract. You are no longer penciled in as a key contributor for the next. Like Des Bryant on Wednesday, you are asked a version of this startling question. You're on the books for an awful lot of money. You think you might need to take a pay cut. I haven't heard no talks about that, but if it comes, well, I don't know, Bryant told reporters. He added, probably not. Hell, no, man. I believe in me. To see Bryant, who will have the team's second largest cap number $16,500,000 next behind only Tyron Smith, defend himself so awkwardly was uncomfortable. He was sheepishly blaming certain situations that I couldn't control while staring down from the cameras. He talked about how he felt he was running routes better than this person, but simply wasn't getting the opportunities. I'm Des Bryant, baby, all day. It's just, you know, it is what it is. That last line, perfectly tailored for an aging prize fighter taking pictures with fans at a trade show, was a particular gut punch. This is Des Bryant, the dominant wide receiver who petrified cornerbacks in single coverage. This is the same unstoppable force in corner end zone jump balls. What is Des Bryant now? With one game remaining in the 2017, Bryant has 66 catches on 124 targets for 6 2-yard counts. The two-count total is the second lowest of his career. The yards per catch are the lowest and the catch percentage is his third lowest. With a sweeping, powerful running game taking hold in Dallas, he has the looks of a player who was merely caught in the transitional phase. Bryant certainly believes the acrobatic, powerful version of himself is out there somewhere. But for the first time, it feels like Bryant is wrestling with how much of the player is left. Fans and reporters have started doing it long ago. For now, Bryant is maintaining the facade of a person he once was. It's much easier than looking at the downside of his career arc to come, not getting this newsletter in your inbox yet. Join the MMQB's morning huddle. Hot reads now on the MMQB. Albert Breer's draft column has the goods. Peter King weighs in on the weirdness in Pittsburgh post James Harrison. Andy Benoit on what to do about Hugh Jackson. Later today, Jonathan Jones on the Carolina Panthers. Callan Carler on how we watch football. Breer on whether it's still a good investment to buy an NFL team. What you may have missed once the catch rule to change. Try complaining at the right time. Why Tom Brady will win the MVP award, and why that's okay. Press coverage 1. Eli Apple was suspended after telling reporters that he needed to use the bathroom instead of commenting on Landon Collins calling him a locker room cancer. Meanwhile, Collins apologized to Apple and Giants interim coach Steve Spagnuolo. What a tangled web they weave in East Rutherford. 2. Mike Malarkey doesn't seem to be concerned about Black Monday with the Titans on the playoff fence. 3. Sam Darnold says he'd be honored to play for any NFL team, rolling Josh Rosen under the bus. 4. Browns coach Hugh Jackson now has to jump into Lake Erie, as if coaching in Cleveland was not difficult enough. 5. Pro Football Focus takes a look at the star-studded Cotton Bowl USC-OSU from an NFL perspective. Big-time quarterbacks, position players and offensive linemen will be on display. 6. Colts coach Chuck Pagano says Sunday is the team's last rodeo. Will it be his as well? 7. If you were making your first NFL head start, who would you tell first? Patrick Mahomes picked mom. 8. Sean McVay has completed his first as a totally cool dude, culminating in the ultimate cool guy move of benching your best players for a meaningless finale. 9. Jared Goff, Carson Wentz and Jimmy Garoppolo are good. The NFL is back from the dead. 10. A swift kick in the fanny by Packers beat reporter Tom Silverstein to Packer management for not getting more active in free agency. Have a story you think we should include in tomorrow's press coverage? Let us know here. The kicker: a genuinely heartwarming moment between Mark Sanchez and the Bears rookie HES mentoring. Also, a great John Gruden impression. Question? Comment? Story idea? Let the team know at talkback@themmqb.com.